Okay, now we are at the Epic Museum here in Dublin, and it is the Irish Immigration Museum about the Irish immigrants and the history of them. So Garvin is inside waiting for me, and he is going to help be my tour guide around the museum. And so here we go. Okay, so we've got our passports.
Yep. Let's see, let's take a look at Lisa's here.
Demons.
Let me see that.
Send you away. Well, in the Epic Art and Museum, if you don't want to read, or even if you're too lazy to watch the videos and listen to people tell the great stories, you can simply come to one of these things.
Ta-da! Oh, look at that! It's been stamped.
So, this is great. This is one of the best parts. Mm-hmm. Tell us about how people left Ireland to do various things, like in the 500s and the 600s, going to places like France and Switzerland and Germany, set up monasteries, all of it.
I still do some heavy work. Where I used to head back most Christmases, I'm more settled
now. I wish to talk to you this evening about the state of the nation's affairs. And the picture I have to paint is not, unfortunately, a very cheerful one. The figures which are just now becoming available to us show one thing very clearly. As a community, we are living way beyond our means.
We have reached agreement on a program for the provision of significant international financial support for Ireland. The outcome here, I believe, is the very best that is achievable for our country. I believe it's the right thing to do.
Thank you. Oh, that's neat. So, how long have the Irish been here?
So kind of the Gaels came to Ireland about 600 BC, so Irish culture is about 26 centuries old, which makes about 1,000 years older than English culture by the same metric. So 26 centuries is pretty old even by European standards.
Yeah.
So the majority of Irish soldiers were in the Spanish army, serving in Spain itself, or Flanders. So from the 1500s in particular, but also the 1600s, Irish soldiers took their families to live in Catholic Europe, that being Spain or France in particular. But they also joined the armies of the Italian states, Prussia, Austria, Sweden, Poland. And this guy here, Patrick Sarsfield, is one of the guys that left after the siege. The Treaty of Limerick was signed in 1691, a treaty that was promising the Irish soldiers that they could continue to live in Ireland and that there would be rights for Catholics, but the English broke the treaty. And so a lot of these guys fled. They were known as the Wild Geese, these soldiers class, this warrior class that existed since forever. And he went and he died in Flanders. And his last words were, "If only this were for Ireland." Mm. If only this had been for Ireland. He said something along that, which has always been like a very kind of, a typical romantic Irish thing to have to die for Ireland.
For he can expect no mercy from me or the Lord Protector. They say he ministers to his rabble flock in disguise. But our Protestant spies are willing and cunning.
So I always feel weird in this corridor. I'm pretty sure this is haunted.
Why do you say that?
It feels like it is.
Okay.
It feels very heavy.
I'll go back. Okay. That's great.
No country contributed more to building my own than your sons and daughters. They came to our shores in a mixture of hope and agony. And I would not underrate the difficulties of their...
So they're going to tell us about who these people are. Cool, huh?
Oh, that is cool. Look at where I'm stepping. And then it moves... That's so cool. And he's shooting. Not at me, but...
She may have be too young to know about the Kelly family, but these guys were very big, particularly in Germany. And then this is the best thing.
Of course. That's what I want to see.
Ross's name, no?
Yeah. But it's Michael Flanagan.
So Riverdance comes to Dublin every summer.
And your places, as such, down there. What happened here? Well, I'm glad you asked. What you can do is you can pick your any sort of postcard that you want that you can send off. So just pick a card, any card.
Oh, wow. Where do I begin? I don't know. I guess this one.
There we go. Okay, so what can you do on this card? Well, I'm glad you asked again. Jeez, you're full of questions today.
I am, yes.
So you have the choice of either drawing, you can also, you can say Lisa mm-hmm. was not writing well. So
yeah, exactly.
You have to use like the biggest part of your finger, but even that is going to touch it all. Or you can type with Magic Keypad, so you can just put that to the side. And you can say, you know, Lisa enjoyed Epic or whatever, or just get your ass to Epic or whatever you're going to say.
Get.
Oops.
You have two options here. You have one, mm-hmm. send us an email to a friend, like literally send a postcard via electronic means.